Is your three-season room freezing in the winter? Let's talk about how foam insulation can help with that. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about how you can make your three-season room more comfortable using foam insulation. Before we get into that, make sure you smash that like button real quick. Okay, so let's get into it. A three-season room. Keep in mind, a lot of these rooms are based off of an enclosed porch. So basically, someone had a porch at some time and then ultimately threw up some walls, mostly windows. We'll get into that in a little bit. And they closed this room off, and now this is a room where people like to lounge, maybe read or something like that, and of course, enjoy the views through the windows. Now, because it was an enclosed porch at one time, these often have no HVAC ran to it. So what that means for you is there's no heat register in the winter. There's no heat pumping into that room. Same thing in the summer. There's no AC that's getting directly sent to that room. Now what this means is there's no heat source, obviously. So in the winter, even if you have the best sealed up insulated walls in the world, if there's no heat source, it's going to be really hard to keep that room warm. So if you don't have a register in there, any type of heat source at all, that's something to keep in mind. Maybe you want to add that. Now, obviously, that will add some steps. You'll have to consult an HVAC contractor. You know, there will be some cost, obviously, that goes into that. So there's one other way around that if you don't want to take all those steps. If your three-season room has a door or, you know, a solid wall that's separating that room from the rest of the house, one thing that you can do in the wintertime specifically is keep that door open. Keep that entryway open into the three-season room. What that does is it allows all the warm air that's inside the rest of the house into the three-season room. If that's completely blocked off, again, you have no heat source. So keep that in mind. Now, is that as efficient as having an actual heat source in the room that's directed to the room? No. But it's if you have all the other things in place, insulation windows that we'll get into, that can help you out and it could get you to your goal. So that's the next thing we're going to talk about is windows. Like we said before, a lot of times these rooms are filled with a lot of windows. That's what we want in those type of rooms. We want some beautiful views. Now, if it's an uncomfortable room, something to consider is you may need to update those windows. Maybe you need to put some high efficiency windows in there that will help retain some of the heat in the winter and help keep some of the heat out in the summer. So keep that in mind, windows will come into play. Obviously, we're going to talk about foam insulation. You want to seal that up because if you have some heat in that room, you want to keep it in. So you want to use an insulation like foam that provides an air seal and establish that building envelope and doesn't let any of that heat get out. So windows, insulate, and make sure you introduce a heat source. Hope this information was helpful to you. Make sure you check out the link in the description below. We have an article that's specific on three-season rooms. It'll get a little bit more in detail than we did here today, so that might help you out as well. Drop us a comment if you have a three-season room. Maybe you have a question that we didn't answer in this, but like I said, that article should help you also. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring that bell so you see all of our notifications. Hey, don't forget, there's also a ton of information on our website, RetroFoamofMichigan.com. We have a learning center on there that is full of all kinds of information, articles, blogs, as well as videos. You're welcome.